In this video, I'll be demonstrating how to replace a broken power button on the Amazon Fire HD10. As you can see, it doesn't click. The device is powered on. To open the Amazon Fire HD10, I like to start on the bottom. Just release all the plastic tabs. Typically, when opening any device, you want to make sure it's powered off. Now that the device is open, I'm going to go ahead and remove all the Kapton tape. I'm going to preheat it before I do it so I could reuse it. I'll go ahead and remove all the screws. Thank you. I always use a flathead to pry the board out. You don't need to disconnect these or desolder these loudspeaker cables. Just be careful when you're maneuvering the board. So right here is the faulty logic board, or excuse me, the faulty power button. So even if you have volume button issues, it's the same component, the same procedure to remove and install a new one. So I have my air pressure set to 70, and the temperature is going to be set to about 245 Celsius. My soldering iron will be set to 750 Fahrenheit. I like to use alloy to thin out the lead-free solder. It's a little easier to remove. I'm going to preheat the board while the soldering iron warms up. This on camera, looks like the plastic piece is what broke off on this one. Use alcohol to clean up the leftover flux. So these two pads are through hole. So it looks like there's still a little solder in there. I'm going to flip the board and get that out. Yeah. Add a little bit more alloy. So as you can see, both the through holes are, you can see that? So I'll make sure the new part fits correctly before I put down some solder paste. As you can see, it fits perfect. Now if you don't have solder paste, you don't need to use it. It just makes installing these parts quite easy. I just use hot air. But you could just hand solder it in as well. So I'm just going to clean up a little bit of the solder. So if you are using solder paste, just keep your temperatures the same. Keep mine at 70 air pressure, 245. Celsius heat. Clean off any leftover flux, make sure it functions. Now I'm just going to go ahead and reinstall the board. Got two tabs on each side of the logic board, or on the middle chassis. Just push those down in there. Gotta make, excuse me, make sure the power button works correctly. Just gonna install a couple screws. And then power the device on. Power button works. So I'll go ahead and finish installing all the screws. Then recover all the connections with the Kapton tape. Putting the rear housing back on, I suggest you start at the top of the device, like this. Insert it in. that power button again. Looks good. That's it. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below.